Chuck Mell is a regular reader of the San Diego Union-Tribune's website. He became a frequent commenter after reading a story about a 15-year-old rock-throwing Mexican boy who was shot and killed by a Border Patrol agent last year. Mell posted a comment critical of the Border Patrol's tactics.
I was astounded by the responses that I got from other people, the hateful, hateful responses.
On many news sites, reader comments sometimes deteriorate into name-calling, racial slurs, even threats. Union Tribune homepage editor Tom Mallory adopted a policy this month that seeks to clean up the comments while avoiding the expense of round-the-clock monitors.
I've had interns moderating the comments and had to warn them, son, I'm going to expose you to the dark underbelly of the human soul here. Are you prepared? It's a very rough place.
Union Tribune readers who want to comment on a news article now must use Facebook to verify their identities.
The real name, the real identity makes debate better, makes conversation better. It brings respect. It brings a level up there that is just lacking when it's Island Pimp 201 versus Res Queer versus this person.
But many regular commenters, including Mel, don't like giving up their anonymity.
So if somebody else is unhappy with something that I have to say, then they have direct access to me in some fashion. They can look my name up in the phone book. They can look me up on the web. They can make me a target.
The Union Tribune says Facebook's identity verification tool will help keep internet bullies at bay.
Looking at this profile, I don't see a lot here that indicates this is a real person.
Other news websites, including the Los Angeles Times and New York Times, are using Facebook to some degree.
So I can see it dampening some of the debate, but I can totally understand why they would implement this policy. You know, if there's a lot of hate speech, a lot of violent stuff, you're going to alienate some readers.
And face it, if you have to say stupid or teabagger or communist, you're not going to convince the other person of your argument.
Mallory says the change has reduced the number of commenters on stories, though he expects a friendlier environment will attract new voices. Not Mel, who may start his own blog to protect his anonymity. Casey Wyand, CNN, San Diego.